adoptees. Thank you everyone for coming. You know, there's one person I have to mention before I start, who many people in this room know, and unfortunately he can't be here with us today. And he was my father, Ken Rose. And I think everyone in here who knew him knew that, A, he was a great athlete, much better athlete than I was. He wasn't my biological father, but he was and will always be my father. But more important than his athletic ability, was he was without a doubt the finest man I've ever met in my lifetime. He would have been more happy about this night than I am, and I'm as happy as I can be. My wife often tells me that I don't pay too much attention to athletics and the results in games, and she's right. She's the smartest person I've ever met. But there's one that's gonna bring me a lot to know. But there are some things that I've learned through participation in sports that are really important and that are critically, they've been very, very meaningful in my life, and they've changed my life in ways that I couldn't even imagine. The obvious things, you know, participating in sports, you remain healthy. I've been blessed to be able to do anything that I've wanted to do to this day at age 55, and travel the world and do things like that. So that's always been wonderful. But more importantly, like many of my people, like many of the other inductees have said previously, things that you learn about hard work, and dedication, and commitment, and diligence, and respect, and responsibility, and thinking about things outside of yourself, and having what happens with your team, your teammates, be much, much more important than what happens with you. Those are the things that transfer, those are skills that transfer to my life, and they're things that have led me to teach. And it's guys like John Iovino and Bob McPhail that I haven't told enough, and Nick Bontempo and John Baldwin, and all these guys that coached me that I haven't told enough, honestly, how incredibly important they were in my life, and how outside of my family, it's guys like them that made me the man and the person I am today, and I'm eternally grateful to them, and I can never thank them enough. You know, growing up here, I love Norwich. But growing up as a young boy, as a young African American boy, it was difficult. You know, I went through things with people and the way that they treated me that wasn't very pleasant. And it had nothing to do with my character or my abilities. It was often just the color of my skin, and I was told that to my face. And I was very, by the time I was 10 or 11 or 12, I was skeptical that there were people out there that could see me just for Jeff Rose and see me just for my abilities. And then I met Bob McPhail, and that changed. And that day, you know, he treated me with complete dignity and respect. You know, he patted me on the back when I needed me. When I needed, he screamed at me. When I needed, he screamed at. And he treated me as if I often played on teams with his son. And he treated me on an equal basis with Marlon. And I will never forget that. And he changed my outlook on life. And then right behind him, guys like John and John Baldwin came along. And changed my outlook, and really changed my life in dramatic ways. And the guys sitting at table 17, who I played with, Billy, Daryl, my cousin Brian, you know, Tommy Roberts, and other guys who are here, and other guys who couldn't make it tonight. I don't have any biological brothers. It's just my sister and I. But I never felt like I didn't have a family. I always felt like I had 30 brothers. And I love you guys more than I can ever tell you. And I thank you so much for always being there for me, fighting with me. Scott Davis, too, I didn't mean to leave you out. I'm sorry. For fighting with me, for winning, losing, battling, laughing, and crying, and dancing, and singing, and joking, and fighting. You know, we did it all. We truly are brothers, and we always will be. And lastly, my family. My two children, Brandon and Courtney. You know, Brandon, thank you for being as passionate about sports as I was, for being my partner over these years. And you are a far better man already and a far better athlete than I ever will be. And I love you dearly. And Courtney, my daughter, she'll always be daddy's little girl, even though she's a grown woman. she has such a powerful spirit. It's always been in place even since ever since the day she was born at Yale New Haven Hospital. She is about ready to make an incredible impact in this world, and I don't even think she understands how powerful she is, and I love her. And lastly, my wife, Patty. My wife, my best friend, the person who taught me how to live each day to the fullest and enjoy it right now, because today is the present, and it is a present. And I love you for that, and thank you so much. And thank you for listening to me for a little bit, and I'm sorry to take up so much time, but thank you, I'm very proud of you.